Welcome, welcome once again back to Scholars and Screens. I'm your host, Jake Buck. Episode 2, part 2, we're going to be taking a look at course management software as it applies to the diffusion of innovations theory. We're going to take a look at course management software interacting in the classroom on the other side of the world. That's right, we've gone global. Scholars and Screens here, episode 2. We're going to hear from the founders of course management software in the classroom today. Moodle, Blackboard, strap in, buckle up, sharpen your pencils, and charge those iPads because we are coming in hot. Scholars and Screens, episode 2. Good news, I've got guests. We're going to be joined today by Kaohsiung American School, all the way on the other side of the globe in Kaohsiung, Taiwan. And we're going to clarify, simplify, and dive a little bit deeper into the diffusion of innovations theory and how that applies to our course management software and this new digital revolution causing the migration from the paper to the screen.
Scholars and screens.
It's all right here. It's coming up next. Stick with us.
Moodle is a free online learning management system that enables educators to create their own private website filled with dynamic courses that extend learning anytime, anywhere. You can install Moodle for free on your own server or ask a Moodle partner to help set up a site for you. Once it's running, you can easily create online courses using our hundreds of built-in features. Upload your content, add gradable assignments and quizzes, and then add collaborative activities like forums, wikis, or glossaries to make online learning scalable, effective, and fun. Because our code is truly open source, you can further tailor your site with a huge variety of community-produced plugins or create your own new features. The Moodle platform is robust with over 10 years of development behind it. And today, more than 70,000 universities, corporations, and schools in over 200 countries and 100 languages trust Moodle for their online learning needs. Moodle, powerful free tools to help you educate the world.
Let's break it down real quick before we get any further and quickly simplify what it is we're going to be talking about here on this webcast series.
The diffusion of
innovations theory is a theory that seeks to explain how and why and at what rate new technologies are spread through cultures. We're going to hear from some of the founders, lead designers, the innovator, the creator, Everett Rogers.
Thank you very much. That was a very nice introduction, and it's very nice to be here at Scholars. Let's now get into my presentation. Just for beginners, here's a quick definition of diffusion. It's heavily a process of people talking to people, interpersonal communication. Here's a definition of an innovation. It's very broad. Innovation is sort of what you think it is. If it's new to you, if you perceive it as new, then it is an innovation. How did I get trapped into this business?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, first, can I ask you the questions?
Sure.
Cool. Back in the United States, did you ever use Blackboard or Sakai or any other course software other than Moodle?
No. I've been here 5 years, and when I left the U.S., I was not using technology very much at all.
Was it a tough?
One thing the kids didn't have access to computers like they do here. Our school here in Taiwan is one-to-one, which means every student has their own laptop with them every day.
Do they all have internet at home?
Yes.
Awesome. And was it a hard learning curve as an instructor to come in and learn how to interact with the students?
It was, but we have a technology staff that consists of the Department of Learning Design that are always available to help us with anything we need help with in the technology field.
Nice. So that's Moodle up on the board behind you.
Yes, it is.
Nice.
This is today's work for the students.
Doesn't look like enough. It looks like they need much more.
Okay, I'll add to it. They'll like that. Always thirsting for the opportunity to do more math. Math is what drives them. Right, Henry?
Yeah, that's the part of being an Asian.
Can we get...
Have any of your students ever taken any completely online classes?
I don't know. Has anybody taken a completely online class?
Alan, who?
Alan, did you take an online class?
No.
College course.
I kind of skipped.
Kind of did.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a definitive answer for you.
Did you, can you tell me, did you like it or did you not like it? Is that why you only kind of took it?
It's kind of boring in a way, because you kind of sit in front of a laptop and then there's no one talking to you, just a screen.
Yeah. Do you think that further on in college that you might take any more online courses, or are you going to try and stick to strictly face-to-face?
I would try to stick to face-to-face, because when you ask a question, there's people answering. Now, like computer courses or online courses, there's no one to answer a question, so.
When did you first have to start using Moodle in school, or when did you first see software like Moodle in school?
7th grade, which is like 6 years ago.
You want to talk to anybody else?
Nope, that's perfect. Unless anybody's like really, really psyched up about Moodle.
Penny loves to talk, just in general. Penny?
Yes.
Penny, can you tell me anything about how you use Moodle? Do you use it on your laptop or a tablet or iPhone?
Yes. I use both on my laptop and cell phone.
Very nice. Can you access it on your iPhone if you need to, or on your smartphone?
Yeah, I can do it on iPhone.
Very nice. Cool.
Thanks.
All right, see ya. Thank you.